for fasting and prayer. What do you pick up as a principle from that? You pick up from a principle from that by understanding, as much as God values marriage and God knows the importance of sex in marriage, and God knowing that there's a fourfold reason around marriage, why he established the marriage covenant. First, it was for companionship. Second, it was for mutual help. Third, it was for sexual fulfillment. Lastly, it was for procreation, in order for God to have family. So God says, you can prioritize, you can, in fact, if you prioritize spending time with me, I give you the right not to be intimate with your wife or your husband. If you prioritize being intimate with me via fasting and prayer, I give you the right to get into a place where you have a right not to be intimate with your wife. Wow. So Paul is actually showing us that if you prioritize intimacy with God, you can suspend intimacy with your spouse. So this points us to the fact that New Testament believers were required to fast. In fact, let me use the right term. They were expected to fast. Even though they had the Holy Spirit, even though they were the temples of the Holy Spirit, they fasted because their salvation and the world they are living in is still progressive. Are we together? Another reason, why do I fast? I fast because Christ, in Matthew chapter 5, verse 16 to 18, gave new ways of fasting. He says, when you fast, don't be like the Pharisees who do it for a public display. If he did not require or expect for them to fast, he would have canceled it. But instead, he gives new ways of fasting, and then he condemns old ways of fasting. Those old ways of fasting were dramatic. They were renting their clothes. Jesus says, you don't rent your clothes anymore. I want you to rent your hearts. He's now telling them, remove the old garments. They will pluck off their hair. They will put on ashes. It was all dramatic as a sign that the man was mourning, and as a sign that the man was seeking God. God was simply saying, when he tells them about the old covenant, I say, please remove the old covenant, because as a testator of the new covenant, I want to teach you new ways of approaching God. So Christ, therefore, encourages me to fast because he's giving me new ways of doing it. In other words, he's condemning old ways of doing it, but he is raising new ways of doing it so that I don't do it the Old Testament way and I cause a rent. The rent becomes worse because I'm mixing covenants and not understanding that I'm no longer required to do certain things. And lastly, why do I fast? First, 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 5. I fast because I am forced by the circumstances of my assignment, like Paul. I am forced. There are certain circumstances that are going to force me to fast. Paul was in his apostolic assignment. He mentions, in fact, let me also give you another verse right there. 1 Corinthians 11, 27. He mentions he's been through hunger and thirst, and then he mentions he fasted often because his assignment forced him to do so. So I fast because of God's assignment upon my life, and I'm forced by circumstances. In Afana, this thing, Mubuti, Agnabu. So why not dedicate a fast? Why not give it to the Lord? Do you understand it? So Paul has been into serious apostolic assignment and apostolic trouble. At some point he went without food. Then he was forced by the circumstances of his assignment to give it to the Lord. Lastly, why do I fast? fast because Matthew 17:21 says, in fact, I fast, because Matthew 21 says, this word or this kind will not come out except with prayer and fasting. So I fast to use fasting as an aid to prayer. In fact, if you fast and you don't pray, it's just a hammer strike. Fasting is an aid to prayer. And why is it an aid to prayer? It's because the disciples were faced with a difficult situation. They were given power to cast out the demon, 9 of them, but they could not cast it out. When Jesus came down with the 3, he said to them, he cast out that demon, and after casting out that demon, he said, ye of little faith, if you have faith like a grain of the mustard seed. It's also another text that is quoted out of context. People are thinking, this is the verse of looking into mountains in Mahalisberg and I'm rooting them by faith. Whereas the example is how a mustard seed is planted and the force it uses in removing a mountain or removing a rock, because it goes deeper, and then as it goes up, as it grows, it removes the rock as it sprouts. That is how you should have persisted. So Jesus is talking about, you were supposed to be persistent, you would have seen results. He did not say, ye of little fasting, he said, ye of little faith. And then privately, when they were together sitting, Lord, why couldn't we cast out? He mentioned something important to say, hey, by the way, this kind does not come out instead of prayer and fasting. But if you read those verses as if the whole episode is happening at the same time, then you miss the plot. So I fast when I'm faced with difficult circumstances. When I feel like, especially if it's related to my assignment and my calling, I feel there's some, then I add fasting as an aid to pray. Are we together? Now let's go to how do we fast, and I'm going to do this one quickly and close. This is what I called the new garment. In fact, the new wine. The old garment is that, remove all those things of renting your clothes, rent your heart. Remove all those things of when you fast, you don't wash yourself, you don't take care of yourself, like the Father, the Old Testament presents this whole thing. But instead, Christ commands, when you fast, wash yourself. And let the other person, because it's a way of you showing devotion towards God. Don't make it a public spectacle. Don't be dramatic about your fasting. Don't go around walking very slow and people are asking you, are you fasting? And you can see, this is not fasting. This is, we are not sure this is suicide or what. And then people start bragging about days, and I'm on 7 days. Yeah. You must know that you already have your rewards.
Yeah.
The minute you make it a public display, you are doing it for us, not to the Lord. Are we clear? Okay. So I just want you, when you engage into this practice, you do it the New Testament way. And you know what is required, and also know what is no longer required. But let's answer. How do I fast? I will explain this. Acts 13 verse 2. I fast with the Holy Ghost. Somebody then asked me, are you saying the Holy Ghost fast? No. I fast with the full knowledge that I have the Holy Ghost. In Acts 13, in the church that was in Antioch, 5 prophets are mentioned and teachers there. And as they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Ghost said, separate me Barnabas and Paul. The Holy Ghost did not suspend or cancel fasting. They fasted and the Holy Spirit was with them and the Holy Spirit spoke the separation of Paul and Barnabas. So we fast with the full knowledge that we have the Holy Spirit. To put it the best way, we fast as we are led by the Holy Spirit. We fast as we are led by the Holy Spirit. Vundis, can I do it voluntarily? Yes, you can. As long as you do it the New Testament way, with the right heart. Secondly, how do we fast? We fast humbly, not like the hypocrites. We fast with humility. Hypocrisy is when you become an actor. You are on public display, as I was explaining, to try to show men how committed you are in the things of God. Whereas inwardly, you do not possess the humility that is required in order for you to meet God. Because God exalts the humble, but he puts down those that are full of pride. So hypocrites fast with pride. In fact, the fasting of the Pharisees was rejected because of pride. Humility. How do we fast? We fast faithfully. What does that mean, Fundis? It means if you said 3 days, no matter the smell of Nando's, any day, if you said 3 days, you must fast seriously. If you said 3 days, I'm going to seek you, Lord, with fasting, be faithful. Don't change it when it gets hard on the second day. Amen. So God knows that he's going to spend time with you for 3 days, and you're committing. It's not a casual thing. You're putting some dedication. If there's dedication in our songs are dedication. I give myself away so you can use me. Our songs are fasting, I tell you. They are so much committed to God, our songs. But then, the commitment from us is another story. How do we fast? We fast also often. We fast often. Why? Because we miss him in a tangible way. Let me tell you why I fast often. As long as when I lay hands on the sick, I don't see the results that I read about in the Gospels, I fast. Because those that were with Jesus, because some of the people were claiming, no, I have the Holy Spirit. Is the Holy Spirit producing the same results like when they were with Jesus, such that miracles cannot be recorded? They cannot be recorded. Books are not sufficient to record the miracles that Jesus performed. John records 7 miracles that are just given in his book to tell us that, or to convince us that Jesus is actually the Son of God. That's why John is very strategic. He only quotes those miracles that are creative. Walking on water, he mentions that, yeah, only God can do that. Turning water into wine, yeah, only God can do that. Healing a man born blind from birth, only God can do that. All the miracles, he doesn't even call them miracles, he calls them signs to point to God. So as long as I don't have results that shows that I possess the fullness of his presence, I will fast often. I'm not motivated by legalistic means to impress or to show or to post. How do we fast? I fast in consideration of the finished works of Christ. So I don't fast for what he has already done for me. Amen. So this is important, considering the finished works of Christ. I am so happy that Jesus never said, when he was hanging on the cross, I am finished. Instead, he said, it is finished. There's a theology that suggests that God was punishing his son, and they look into this father-son relationship, and they call it cosmic child abuse. They don't understand that God was in Christ, reconciling the world to himself. And as we are going towards the Easter, please preach it correctly. When he cried and said, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, there was no separation between God and God. There was a separation between God and man. Christ, by definition, theological, in the Trinity, is one nature, 3 persons, Get it right. One nature, three persons. Christ is one person, two natures. One person, two natures. He added the human nature into the divine nature as one person. 100% God, 100% man. He is the God-man, not the daily God. He is not half God. 100% God, 100% man. So, when he said, I thirst, as a man, he was thirsting for God. And as God, he was thirsting for man. So when he shouted, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, it was not the broken trinity. It was a cry of agony from the human nature because of him absorbing the anger of God. So if you say, Lutsamakama, I said it just once, so you can understand that you can't be heretic on that one. But it becomes heretic when you misrepresent Christ, because the Bible is about the doctrine of Christ. So I'm glad he said, it is finished. Tetel, let's die. Rather than for him to say, I am finished. Thank God for Jesus Christ. Yeah. Number seven, I fast devotionally. If you fast and you don't pray, forget about fasting. If you fast and you continue with work, at least find time to pray. Because without prayer, it is not fasting. You might as well feast. Fasting, if it's simplified, the opposite of feasting. Because fasting is not being against food. All food belongs to God. Thank you. And you should receive it with thanksgiving. Number eight, why do I fast? Isaiah 58. I fast with a generous spirit. So if I know that I'm going to fast for 3 days, so I know there's breakfast, lunch, and supper. It means I am going to give my breakfast to someone, my lunch to someone, my supper to someone. So that you fast with a generous spirit. I can fast about a stinch. You fast and then you shake it in now or so. Or hey, you shall be using sizzle. We don't fast like that. We are not going through punishment when we fast. We are seeking God. So don't look punished when you fast. Do it with a generous spirit. Are we still together?
Amen.
Two more points and I'm done. When you fast secretly. Not unless you have collective fast, we can call corporate fasting. It's not a problem. But when you fast as an individual, fast secretly. If you need to tell your roommate, okay, it makes sense. Say, oh, for the chiefs, just for the view, I'm going to suffer. Amen. Yeah. Just apply common sense, but you fast discreetly. Because God who sees you in secret will be one to open the Lord Jesus said. And last, we fast collectively. So this is how, as I go through the scriptures and debating the whole issue of fasting in the New Testament versus the Old Testament, and reconciling with Jesus' answer. Jesus gives the reasons why we fast, which I have given. Jesus gives the old garment that needs to be put away, all the drama of what you see in the Old Testament. He says there's a new way of fasting, and then he calls it the new one. So, in conclusion, what are we saying doctrinally? We are saying, as believers in the New Testament, we still seek God, not because we don't have Him, it's because we are not experiencing Him in His fullness. Only the Son of God has Him in fullness. Even the grace that supports an apostle, prophet, pastor, evangelist, and teacher, it comes measured. They come to contribute. He who ascended when he ascended, or the same one who ascended is the same one who descended. And when he ascended on high, he took captivity captive. In other words, he captured some and he released some. And then he gave gifts unto men. And he gave some to be apostles, prophets. We are the body of Christ, and what do we? Members in particular. The fullness is upon us corporately. So I still fast because I want to experience his fullness. I'm seeking his presence. I am not fasting for his presence. I am fasting in his presence. So may God help us. I hope you set this the argument. And God bless you. Amen.